This is our first video, operating instructions for Klystron power supply. We will give you operating instructions for VSWR meter also in our next video. So this is your Klystron power supply. So before turn on this power supply, we have to follow some precautions for safety purpose. So that is, this is beam now. So we have to keep it at minimum position, means fully rotate anti-clockwise. And this is zippler knob, this should be at maximum position, means you have to keep at maximum, fully rotate clockwise. And then these all knobs, this is AM and this is FM modulation knobs, this is for frequency, this is for amplitude, these all keep at middle positions. And modulation, you select AM for your experiments, it is enough, AM is suitable. And meter select you keep anywhere, it's not a problem. Now it is in voltage, that is beam voltage, next beam current and rippler. So HT should be towards off, this is HT switch, this should be towards off. Then you turn on the power supply. Okay, now you can turn on this HT. When HT is on, your beam supply and rippler supply is connected to your output. Otherwise, it will not connect to your circuit also. So it is safety. So now when I am doing conducting experiment, I am taking readings, then I will turn on this when I will start my experiments. So it is now on, so I am getting beam supply, I can vary this beam supply, and this is rippler. Here is the modulations, we have selected AM modulation. So after connecting this power supply to Klystron tube, it will generate RF signal from 8 to 12 gigahertz. In between 8 to 12 gigahertz, any one frequency it will generate. But after receiver, means crystal detector, in the end it will receive the RF signal, but our CRO or VSWR meter is not able to read RF signals. So our CRO, normally analog CRO operates maximum 30 megahertz or DSO 100 megahertz, but our RF signal is gigahertz. So what we will do, we will modulate RF signal with a low frequency. In this power supply, AM modulation is from 500 hertz to 1500 hertz. So after detection, we will receive that 500 to 1500, whatever the frequency set here. This is frequency and this is amplitude, these two knobs for AM and these two knobs for FM. FM from 200 hertz to 800 hertz, internal oscillator is there for both AM and FM. So AM 500 hertz to 1500 hertz, FM 200 hertz to 800 hertz. So this low frequency will be demodulated, and then we will measure these signals, not RF signals. Our CRO will not show gigahertz signal, our VSWR meter also not read these RF signals. After detection, only low frequency only we are reading. And CW mode is there, continuous wave means continuous RF, so we are not using right now. And FM also, it is in telecom or other branches, they will do mode characteristics. There it is useful. And external modulation is there. Suppose if you keep it in external modulation, you have to give an input for external modulation. BNC socket is there. 1 kilohertz signal, 2 volt peak to peak from FG. External, you have to take one FG and connect this. So it is useful when internal modulation failures. Suppose your examination is going on, suddenly AM modulation failure, you are not able to contact your service provider immediately because exam is going on. So by the time you connect on external FG with 2 volt peak to peak, 1 kilohertz. This 1 kilohertz, why we are specifically telling our VSW, or normally every college using VSWR meter for measurements. This VSWR meter is tuned for 1 kilohertz. It will operate in 1 kilohertz only. Maybe 50 hertz plus or minus 50 hertz, there may be a variations or deviations. So in power supply also we can vary. The frequency is variable. So you can tune it exactly when we are getting a maximum power in VSWR meter before starting the experiment. You have to adjust this to VSWR meter in which frequency it's working. Suppose it is working 1 kilohertz, okay, why you have to set 1 kilohertz. Suppose 980 hertz it's working, then you have to tune it and you have to get the maximum power at VSWR meter. This is power supply output octal socket connector details. So here it is a 8 pin connector, 1 and 8 beam supply, 180 volt DC to 450 volt DC, pin number 1 and 8. 1 is anode and 8 is cathode. And 2 and 7 heater filament voltage, filament supply, 6.3 volt DC. No need of polarity, you connect in any way, plus or minus is not important. And next, fifth pin, rippler voltage, it is up to 270 volt DC, at least you maintain minimum 50 volts, it's safety for your klystron tube. Pin number 5, with respect to ground pin number 8, cathode pin. So we are collecting output from the klystron power supply through this socket. It will connect it to microwave bench where tube is connected, klystron tube. I will show you tube also. Here is the meter selection switch is there. First one is beam voltage, second C is current, beam current, and R is rippler. Third one is rippler voltage, all three. Only one display, we have to read all three. Where you keep the switch, that will be displayed on 7 segment display. So now it is in voltage, beam voltage, so 200 volts. I can vary this voltage up to 450 volts. So next thing is current. I am not connected output to any load, so there is no current right now. And rippler voltage up to 270, it will come 267, it is also variable. Okay, so one display, three readouts. Klystron power supply not generating any RF signal. So Klystron power supply output is for beam, it will start from 180 or 200 up to variable up to 450 volts. Start from 180 approximately and up to 450 volts variable DC beam voltage, and next rippler from 0 to 270 negative minus voltage. It will start from 0 to up to 270, but at least you maintain minus 50 and above only, means operating voltage from minus 50 to minus 270 for safer side. Your tube will not damage. If the rippler voltage 0, maybe your tube damage. So please maintain from minus 50 to minus 270. Don't keep less than minus 50, minus 40, minus 30, minus 20 or 0. It's
dangerous for your tube. Filament voltage 6.3 volt DC. That is also DC. And AM FM output is there. AM is around 500 to 1500 hertz. In hertz, not in kilowatts also. Maximum 1.5 kilohertz. And FM from 200 hertz to 800 hertz. All in few hertz only. There is no RF signal. Klystron power supply not generating any RF signal. Klystron tube, you are connecting this power supply to Klystron tube. Tube required all this power supplies, modulation, whatever the given beam, rippler, filament, all required to tube. After connecting this power supply, Klystron tube is oscillator that will generate RF signal around 8 to 12 gigahertz. We cannot variable from 8 to 12 complete frequency range. Any one frequency it will generate with some 100 or 200 megahertz variable electronic tuning. So clear, Klystron power supply not generating any RF signal. Please contact us for demo, quotations, service, projects, internship for students.